Nowadays, nothing really excites me. Only one of me and nobody's like me. Phone ringing and I tell him it's icy. I got wifey on, blinging, she icy. Freeze, photo, please, no photos. G's, no, please, no photos. Hit the door and the dome and just whole team here, might need some.
So, I'm gonna do this section by section. I'm gonna do the back half first. This is just a closure. I thought I'd do it on one of my own old closures. So I washed this today and then I was bored and I started waving it, crimping it. Then I thought, nah. So here we have an adjustable waver. You can actually have three kind of different styles. When it's flat, you get more of a wave. When it's higher, it gets quite aggressive. So I prefer it at this level. Let's say like one kind of twist. And what you have to do is hairspray your hair so it holds. Brush your hair through with the sheen. If you've got any sheen or heat protector. This is the Icy Fantasia. This is the, so I'm gonna just do it from a bit of a distance. So you turn it on, turn the heat up to 230. So it does that until it reaches the temperature you are happy with. So I'm gonna spray my hair. I forget that I have to do all this when I do crimps. Oh my God. But you want it to stay, you know, and be real defined. So I start here, hold it there, and then I go to the indent and place the rod on the indent. Then I go to the next indent. And I repeat. So you literally do that along the whole hair. You do that along the whole hair. Okay, oh, this is gorgeous. Oh my God, yeah. I think the setting that I put on, guys, is perfection. I'm in love with this. So I'm switching on the hot comb and I'll put it on the highest heat. Now, guys, one thing I'll recommend, yeah, is doing your hair and then makeup. I was tripping, boy. So you guys know how to use hot combs. I'm not taking it all the way down though. You don't want it too silky because the crimps will drop. We're literally just doing the top half, flattening the top half. But yeah, so there we go. It's flat. It's also flat in the back. Now let me tell you guys a funny story. It's not even a funny story. It's quite an annoying story when I think back at it. But I remember when we were in our first tiny store, yeah. So we started in a small store that Sharon was already at, and trust me, it was tiny, tiny. And like, it had so many issues, like it just wasn't containing everything that we needed. It was just, it was time for an upgrade. Oh no, so this is even before we moved, sorry. We tried to renovate it because we would get leaks. Oh my days. I don't know if anyone remembers that has been to Doll before, but we used to, like, if it would rain, it would rain through the shop. No joke, there would be buckets on the floor. It was the ghetto. It was the ghetto. So obviously it came time to call in those roof people. So we did exactly that. We found someone on Gumtree. I don't know why we found someone off Gumtree, but we found someone on Gumtree and decided that that would be the guy that we trust with thousands of pounds to renovate our shop. So his job was to fix the leak in the roof, one. And what else was he to do? Take apart the walls, sand the walls. He just had a shitload of jobs to do. I'm gonna find a picture of him and I'm gonna show you guys the picture. So this guy's like, yeah, he needs to get the materials, which to be fair is normal, and he needs money for the materials.
Yeah, it's gonna be 30 now. It's gonna be really dusty.
Yeah. So how long will the shop have to be empty for?
I'd say 2 days.
2 days?
Yeah.
What, to do the inside and the outside?
No, the outside you can still carry on.
I mean, you
need to do the outside,
yeah,
before you do anything on the inside.
Yeah, and then what would the inside require?
Wait, you need to take the ceiling down, new plasterboard,
yeah,
and then replaster it. Because you can't, I mean, if I was to push that, that's ready to come down, so just be careful with people in here, yeah?
Yeah.
Because that's quite a thick ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
So if that comes down, that's going to hurt someone.
So we paid like a deposit, and he started the works, guys. He started the works, as in, he started tearing down the walls. He was on the roof every day for like a week, saying that he was fixing things, right? So he was on the roof, and then he was also pulling down the walls and kind of gutting the entire shop. So we're thinking he's doing his job, but then he starts asking for more money to get more tools. So at this point, we've probably sent him like 3K, 4K, and eventually, guys, this guy just disappears. This guy ghosts us, and we're messaging him, and he's just straight up airing us. I think he even starts laughing at us. Like, his name was like Gary or something. Yes, it was Gary the Builder. There's no message history. No, there's no message history, guys. When you are doing your renovations of your stores or anything of the sort, please do a thorough check. Because niggas out here is trifling. And apparently this guy has done it before. I think we put up his picture somewhere. And we even Googled like his fake business name. And there was so many reviews. Had we just done like further checks, like there were so many reviews, guys. Like, this guy's a fraud. This guy's this. And we was like, oh my days. And this was so mad because we had a set time frame of when we were supposed to be back in action, like taking bookings again. And we were just pissed. We were so pissed. We had to reschedule everybody. And like, it was just so unnecessary, man. Especially at the beginning stages. Who wants to be taking L's? We were pissed. So guys, obviously after taking a mad L, we can't find like mad expensive professional people. So we went to B&Q and we picked them niggas up from the streets. We picked them up from the streets, but they were ready. They said they can do this, they can do that, they can do this. They said, yeah, we'll be fast. Oh, they said a lot of things. If I can insert clip, I will insert clip.
Sand and cement, and I mix it. I make do the concrete. I do the concrete.
They also wasted our time. We had to redo the floors about 2 or 3 times. And then I think they did something, they messed up our electrics. We then had to get an electrician in. They also lied about the time frame. Nah. Guys, we've really suffered in this life. We have really suffered. But yeah, it's a learning experience. Okay, let me shut up and just focus. Oh, guys, this is gorgeous. Oh my God. This is quite hot, but not hot enough to burn you. So, that's another good thing. But crimps do get very hot. If you guys saw what I was using before, I'm not even saying this because this is ours, but this is a bloody upgrade. Amazing. Am I done? I'm done. Let me not mess up my hair. Yeah, shit, I'm done. Oh, love it. I prefer this side. I feel like I need to go through this side with the hot comb because it's a bit. Oh, wow, that is hot. Do hot combs really need to be that hot? Feels like I've been
but feeling like I'm all alone. You don't seem to want me, even though you took
stunning. I wish my closure was longer too. That would be a nice, like, yeah. I'm so happy with this. I'm so sweating. I am mad happy with this. Yeah. Okay, so guys, I am very happy with this look. The fact that I did it myself just made me extra happy. But yeah, so I'm actually gonna take this off, hang it up, and it should be intact by tomorrow. I'm gonna hairspray it one more time so that nothing moves. But to be fair, crimps really don't be moving anyway. Yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. If you've got any more videos, as I always say, request, like, comment, subscribe. I'm gonna go do some other shit, take some selfies and that, because yeah. Why wouldn't I? I look fly as fuck. I look like I'm going somewhere that I'm not because we're locked down, but yeah. Thanks, guys. Thanks for watching. And I will add the links to the products down below. Peace.